So the next thing we want to do, we want to filter the data for this business process to only process a specific order. So just like before, we're going to add an input parameter, which means we're going to use the value, number, and get the order ID. And we're going to say where add order details dot order ID is equal to the order ID that we receive as a parameter. Let's run this. Again, I'm going to do the split screen. And run the get order statistics. And now it's going to ask for an order ID because we need parameters. So I'm going to say 10500. Run. And we can see the constructor was executed, the onload, before the execute, onload, onStart, enter row, leave row, enter row, leave row, and unload and after exit. Great. So we can see exactly what was going on. We can see that it iterated the two rows that exist for order 10500 and performed the enter row and leave row for each and every one. Now, some of you may notice that it didn't do the on saving row, and that is because the row was not changed. If we made a change to the row, then the on saving row event would happen and it would save to the database. Great. So now that we see all of that, let's go ahead and clear all the debug write lines that we don't really need. We just use them for our understanding. Pretty much take all of this and delete it. And now we have our very simple controller that is a business process because it inherits from business process base. It uses the order details table as the main data source. It accepts the order ID parameters and filter accordingly, and then executes. Great.